Hey guys, welcome to the Sunday Dev Hangout. It is Sunday the 5th of October. Today we are, you have to excuse me while my camera's not showing, I'll pop up in a bit. So today we're going to be covering the Arbalest unit, which is on screen now. We shall take you through some of the animations and we'll have a look at him. And her, actually, although I can't show the female in this one, but she's ready. We will be taking a look at the work in progress of the Swamp Environment Kit. As usual, we'll be giving away a folktale key on Steam. So hang around in and watch the Hangout for more information on how to enter that. If you don't already follow us on Twitch, then click the follow button. All your followers are greatly appreciated. Alternatively, you can follow us on Twitter, which is at Games Foundry, or you can subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/GamesFoundry. Okay, so this is the long talked about Arbalest unit. It's undergone a name change this week. It was previously called Crossbowman. We've had a long debate in the forums about the best names that don't have the word men in the title. And we've settled for now, at least, on Arbalest, which is an historical name for crossbowmen. Arbalest is a crossbow, but it's spelled different. Arbalest, I should say, is the French name for a crossbow, and an arbalest is somebody who uses an arbalest. So anyway, this is a little mock-up that we've done for animation syncs. So what we do typically is we'll set up a little prototype with the character in there, and I can run and shoot and collapse and things like that, and then I'll use those for syncing the sound effects too. So we can take a look around this guy. He's got a diffuse map, which is the painted sort of color, and it's also got a spec map, so you'll see like his helmet and metal bits shining. And now he's fairly well armed, I would say. He'll wear chainmail, both leather and chainmail. So he's sort of an intermediate unit. It's not your plate armor sort of city watch, who are hardcore sort of melee units. This guy is still medium armor, so chainmail's pretty good. You won't be able to make it at the very start of the game. They are designed really to man your city walls, but also you'll be able to take them on attacks as well. So what we're looking at the moment is we've got the idle position, and I can make him walk. So I've got these all these commands on shortcut on the keyboard, and then we can go into the run. And then we can give him sort of a random idle animation. So most of the time he'll just stand around doing this. And then to make them feel alive, we'll just sort of trigger the occasional idle animation. And quite often they'll say something humorous. We can then shoot and he'll go into the melee idle animation, which is this sort of targeting. So when he's under threat or there's a battle going on, he'll be in this pose as opposed to this. This is the more relaxed pose that he's in. And then, so when he's in combat, he'll basically rearm, and the weapon's animated, and you'll see the string of the bow, same as the archer. What I'm not showing here is the fact that they will also change the angle of elevation on their arms, and we have to set up the animation slightly differently for that. So if he's upon the walls, like in the tutorial, quite often the ranged units would shoot and it would look weird because the arrow would basically shoot downwards, although he's aiming horizontal. Now we fixed that in Sandbox, and now they actually change the angle of elevation so they shoot down or up or wherever the target is, basically. And then we've got the collapse animation. So when they're dead, but they'll go back into normal animation, so they might be running, and then they might get under fire, boom, and then they'll die. We've got a couple of things to tweak on this, things that we need to think about. So if this guy is standing on a wall, then we don't want his gear sort of dropping where they are currently, because they'll be floating out in the middle of thin air. So it's just stuff like that we've got to think about and tweak. But this guy should be working his way into patch 0.2.10 in a couple of weeks' time. So yeah, that's the Arbalest unit. He's going to make a big difference, I think. It's put them on top of your walls and mow down those goblins. Alright, so just a reminder that we do post the videos of the Hangouts on YouTube, usually on Monday. So if you want to take another look at the Arbalest unit, then you can do, and watch there. So, without much ado, we will skip across. Just bear with me for a second. Oops, not that one. And let's jump in to the game. Now, what I'll do is I've just messed around. We only, I only got my hands on the start of the Swamp Environment kit on Friday. So I've tried to tinker with it on Saturday morning a little bit. Excuse me. Now, actually, before we do that, I've got a few caveats to run through because this is very early whip. So let me just jump across to those. So it is very early look. There's no ambient set at the moment. It's the same ambient settings as the Grasslands kit. So the lighting, the fog, the watercolour, the day and night cycle colours, all of that is going to be using the Grassland kit for now. We will, of course, be changing that in due course. There is only one kit available that I'm working with at the moment, which is the Swamp Environment kit. There will be other kits coming soon, which are either nearly ready or are in production. Those include the monster kit. Now, we've got some monsters that haven't been seen yet that we'll be revealing, presumably in one of the dev hangouts before one of the blogs. In terms of the architecture kits, I'll just skip forward one. The Swamp Architecture Temples kit is nearly ready. It wasn't quite in a form ready to share today, but we will definitely have a look at that hopefully in next week's stream. Navmesh settings on kit pieces aren't fully working at the moment, so I can't fully run over bridges and things like that. We're just in the process of tweaking those. When we do ship this, which is very possibly in 0.2.10, so you guys can start creating some swamp maps, don't use the swamp kits with the grassland kits, because that'll consume a lot of memory on your graphics card and system RAM. But we are designing the kits to be mutually exclusive. There's nothing to stop you combining them for the time being. You know, if you want to sort of make something that looks nice, then feel free. But when it comes to sort of production level maps, then don't combine those. There'll be pieces that we'll be introducing, like campfires and things like that in time. And then there are no sound effects added other than the ones that are in the grassland kits at the moment, so it will sound more swampy as we get there. Okay, so with that said, let's jump in. And the first thing I'm going to do actually is I'm going to fire up the new console that we'll be shipping, and I'm going to switch it today. Now, the console you can bring up by holding down Control Shift and X on Windows. I think it's Command Shift and X on OS X. Another thing we haven't done is the grass at the moment is still the Grasslands kit, so it's the green hue doesn't match the swamp. And these maps are really for adventuring on. We may change it so that, you know, they're designed so that you can play on them, which I can actually do now. So I'm going to go ahead and do that now, build up a little bit of a settlement in the swampland, because there are some monsters that I've included in this. But we will take our time and look at some of the pieces. So this was originally geometry that was included in the tutorial outside the Goblin Barbican. Let's bring me up. Hey guys, sorry about the no camera. And these were initially outside the grassland, the Goblin, what was it called? Oh heck, I've forgotten what it's called now. Anyway, the entrance to the Goblin area. And we've brought those in now, as well as the bushes, so we've got different hues of bushes in there. So there's quite, being the swamp, there are quite, there's quite a few vegetation pieces. That you'll see. Some of the other things.
Yep. Run over my pleasure. To... On my way.
Let's see where we're going. We've obviously got these cool sort of spewing, toxic-looking.
Ta-ta.
Tree stumps.
Really?
A couple of those.
Okay.
Right to the edge of the map.
My pleasure.
Just to give it a bit of mood.
On my way.
So when we're looking at this, obviously imagine. You know, more fog and much more mood. Gok Turksman's asking why no resolution options for your streams. Because we're not a Twitch partner, so you need 500 concurrent viewers. And obviously, we've only been streaming for a bit, and that number will creep up in time. And it's only Twitch partners that can that has the resolution option shown on the stream. Okay, let's just pull up the console again. So Control Shift X and just run day again, and then Escape to close the console. I'll go more into that console later as well. But that's something else that's shipping in 0.2.10. It will remove things like the God shortcuts and things like that, and they'll go into the console. So if you've ever used anything, I'm trying to think, years back now, I think like Doom and Quake had consoles. So let me just catch up on the chat because there's some questions being asked. And so what I'll just repeat something that our Fox has said in the chat, which is we're also planning on some generic kits, things like and we'll move things like campfires and maybe like walls and things like that into those kits, and then they can be used across all the different biomes. So the swamp is a biome, the grasslands is a biome. You know, there'll be like a snow biome. Let's see, a cheeky little swamp beast walking around up there. So just bear with me while I catch up. Yeah, so Matt is saying that swamp kits should lock out grassland kits. Yeah, they will do. I will try and keep my eyes on the chat channel. Okay, so looking at something's chugging a little bit for some reason. Let's see what other pieces we've got.
Ta-ta! Really?
Now, if I just sort of look up the camera, one thing you will see is that we've put in massive trees. So when you're looking down, what we're talking about doing is maybe building a canopy level. So as you look up, at the moment you obviously can't see anything but clouds. But when you look up, we want you to feel that you are actually in the swamp itself. Nersal's asking, why is there a 30 FPS option in the game? Because not everybody's graphics cards are ultra powerful. So if it's sort of you're getting screen variation. Just one moment, please. Okay. Just catch up. Yeah, so why is there 30 FPS? So if your frame rate is jumping between 30 FPS and 60 FPS consistently, you may find that that starts to sort of mess with the controls or feels a little bit jerky. So as you're scrolling, it will go fast and then slow and fast and slow. So you might want to lock it at a slightly lower frame rate. And you know, being a strategy game, RTS game, that's fine. You don't need necessarily 60 FPS like you do in a first-person shooter. Kirogm was asking, can we teleport from town to swamp with more than one person? So the way that we're designing it is, so all of these sort of sections are designed for adventuring, and you will take your adventuring group, which will consist of four, so that it's much more like a traditional RPG in that sense. So the loot that you find, there'll be a loot that relates back to your village, but also loot that you'll want to equip on your heroes. So you'll be able to join them together, and you'll be able to take your party, adventuring party, from your city that's in the grasslands, and take the adventuring party that you've configured to an area like this. Oh, right, yeah. MBMCZ has just mentioned about the audio volume. I forgot to do that. My apologies. I'll do that now. Hey to everybody, all the regulars that are joining us now. Alright, so where
all right, my love.
Where are my guys? Okay, right.
You can okay.
So let's start building. We'll explore this map as we sort of go along, and I'll look at various pieces. So the first thing to do, let's get some more folks. So let's just knock in one in there. And while they're building that, I will try and catch up on chat. Mitjo123, yeah, there will be a Steam key, just a single one, given away at some point during the stream. So if you want to be in with a chance of winning that, you need to be watching the stream at the right moment. But this isn't, we don't give away lots and lots of keys like other channels for beta access and things like
building
that.
Building completed.
It's a full key for the complete final version of the game.
New villagers have arrived.
Matty, I mean, yeah, we're braced for abusing these pieces. By all means, do that and communicate to us, you know, extra pieces that you want. So let's pop down.
New villagers have arrived.
Pop this, let's pop that there. So while they're building that, let's get, so we've done fisherman. No, I did plonk one down. One thing that's like resources, this is, I've not really built up this area with stone, so it looks a little bit weird. But
building completed.
Drop a little stone cutter in there. I've just dropped one in so that it plays a little better. So obviously we don't have any resources.
What now?
You can go fishing. Now, there's some other stuff that I want to share with you in today's stream.
Building completed.
So the first thing we'll do is we'll use the console to equip, or to give ourselves one of everything. So I'll do that. I'll just close that down. And now, so the console is really a dev tool that we can use, but also you guys can use. So if you're testing your own maps and you know you die hideously and you don't want to start over again, then you can just use the console to cheat. So there'll be a full write-up in the guide on that. Nursel's asking, will there be 120 FPS option in the game? It's unlikely. I mean, you could certainly turn off VSync, and if your card is ridiculously powerful, then and you can reach that sort of speed, then you know it'll be unconstrained, uncapped. All right, so let me just quickly catch up, because there's a lot of chat going on at the moment. So just bear with me, please. Gok Turksman is asking, can we help to translate the game to, for example, my native language? There was some work done on... it's probably going to get wiped out. There was some work done on a translation tool, which we suspended because we, given after user feedback, we need to do some more work on it. Oh dear. Let's get rid of this guy. Sorry, let's cheat. And let's just send him over here. Because we don't want him to destroy our town just yet.
New villagers, have a
yes, dear. All right, dear. Right away. Okay.
We're also doing some work on our own sharing services. So at the moment, people sharing maps. Bear with me, turn it right down. People are sharing maps in the forums at the moment, and it's not ideal. So we are putting in share services that's kind of like Steam Workshop. And you'll be able to actually upload and download location maps, world maps, character designs, and
new
language packs.
Have arrived.
So it is something that we'll be adding in future. But more information about that will be posted in time on the forums. Ord's asking, will the swamp
new
kit make it to into 0.2.10? Yeah, what we're showing today is most likely going to make it in. It may be a bit rough and ready. You know, there might be some nav mesh issues due to configuration of all the pieces and stuff, but we'll try our best to ship the kit that I'm showing off now. So let's go and just set our stonecutter working, and we'll plonk down a woodcutter. Let me squeeze that in there. Yes, we can.
New villagers have arrived.
Okay.
New villagers have arrived.
Yeah, this is not the
building
type of game where the difference between 60 FPS and 120 FPS is going to matter much. Okay, so the next thing I want to do is let's get some farming going. So. Where can we pop some fields down? If we sort of I just wonder if we're going to be able to pop some fields down here. I should really have plonked the fields down first, shouldn't I? Let's see if we can plonk that one there. Okay. So this is what I'm saying, you know, this stuff that we haven't configured yet. So at the moment I can
building
build over
completed.
A tree.
Building completed.
We'll do it anyway.
Building completed.
Okay. Let's send a couple. Got a couple of farmers. We're getting good population here. What, 12 or 10? That's interesting. Not quite sure how that went. There are no deer at the moment, so we won't bother with that. We'll.
New villagers have arrived.
We'll do. We'll probably want to build a wall. Oh, I don't know if I've got enough.
New villagers have arrived.
Okay, so while they're building the tier one wooden palisade, let's build a few more things. Let's build a barracks because there is something that I want to show you, and I need to plonk it down early. because space is a little bit of a premium. As I say, I only messed around with this on Saturday morning. I'll try and... What we'll do is we'll just put some repeating crossbows up there, and then hopefully they can take care of that.
Building completed.
Something to do?
My He's going to walk
a woman's work wall, is never done.
Alright, we took him out anyway. Is he going to drop some loot? Alright, it doesn't look like he dropped any. That's that bug that needs fixing. So Owen Snowden is asking, so how much loot will the game have? Hopefully lots. We keep adding to all the loot that's posted on the website and the game guide under the items section. So if you want to keep an eye on that, we keep adding, you know, armor sets at the moment. We're trying to focus on the stuff that you're going to need in patch 0.3. So we're adding things like common, uncommon and rare cloth armor, chainmail, plate mail, same with weapons, some tools, all of the crafting ingredients, things like medicine that the herbalist makes, and the potions, and so I mean there's a lot of work. We've actually got two people working on all of the loot icons. It's not just icons, some of the things like weapons have to be made into 3D as well. Can we lock a wall down? No. Right, okay. Let's maybe get some stairs there. Get some stairs. No. Okay. Alright, never mind. So there'll be a fair amount, I would say. There's a lot of icons already. And we're only sort of... I wouldn't want to say how many there are in total. It's hard to say. We're just going to keep going, really. One thing that we haven't really made at the moment is like the epic loot. Which will be related to quests and all the quest items and stuff like that. So yeah, that's a fair amount to make.
What now?
All right. Who's that? Hello. A little kobold came walking over. Right. For some reason, they're not dropping loot. Anywho's. Right. I wanted to train some militia because I wanted to show you something else that the team have been working on. Actually, I say the team, it's what Aaron's been working on, so there's a little bit of programmer art in there, which is really just for testing mechanisms. So another caveat is that we'll go back in and we'll be changing all of the artwork. But what we've got working at the moment, and the reason why...
Villagers have arrived.
Ready to serve.
Let's just go.
All right, my love.
So these are your plate armor-wearing guys. We've added in... attributes to the gear. So, and special abilities. So, where was that plate? So, if we go and filter by armor, so we've got all of the new armor in there, which I'll just sort of drop on this plate. Oh, that's interesting. It sounds like it's playing the leather armor. Almost plate. Yeah, it sounds like it's playing the wrong sound effects for that. So. But anywho, the weapon that I actually wanted to equip, so I filter by weapons, is I wanted to equip that one. All right. And
yes,
then I want to give this one another one, and I'll go into what's happening on screen. I think that's the right one. Yep. Right, a couple of things happening here. First thing is that this... item that this person, that Tricky Cornwallis is carrying. It's not going to show at the moment, but it's actually got a healing aura on it. Let me just check. Yeah, so it's a healing aura. So anybody that's within the radius will benefit from that healing aura. So it's a heal over time, essentially. So when you're in combat, they will heal.
Ready!
And that is a passive ability, so that is always on.
Petal.
Now, it's not necessarily related to gear. It might be a special ability of a character or a class, a profession, or a hero, should I say. So this is just sort of Dev showing the mechanics of how they'll work and how they'll be implemented, rather than this is the heal aura, this is what it's going to look like. It's more about how it's going to function.
All right, my love.
Now, this pickaxe that I equipped has actually got some special abilities on it. Which the first one is lifesteal. So any monsters caught within the radius will actually start losing life. So it's a bit like a necromancer's sort of weapon. Which, actually, is that being... Yeah, that's passive. We've got a meteor storm, so...
Yes, my dear.
Am I running the right build here? Yes, I think I am.
How can I help?
Just bear with me. There we go. Alright, so this is a targeted effect. So that was a meteor storm. So what I've done is I've clicked on the special ability, and then it'll be a different targeting cursor. And it will actually heal them. So if I sort of fire it down here. Now that person's got damage. Now if I bring them into the... There you go. See, the health went up really quickly. But because they came into the aura...
Something to do?
I'll just do it one more time. They'll run away in fear. Oh, yeah, actually, it's, the hill's obviously overpowered at the moment, but
yes,
you get the idea. And we've got like a mass heal. So actually, if we heal ourselves, I kind of really I need to be out of the aura, so let's do that now. Oh, that's interesting. He didn't get hit. I guess there was no collision. Okay. Maybe the caster's immune to it. Maybe it didn't... Okay, not quite sure what that's...
Yes, we do.
There's also electrocution, but I'm not quite sure why that's... Oh, there we go. All right. as I say, these are just tests. So if I just go in close and then electrocute... so it's not fully implemented at the moment, but it's just a little funny thing. So we're starting to play around. This is really a precursor. We're not going to be putting huge amount of effort into that. It's really a precursor for me to be able to set up all of the attributes on all the gear items. But you can see how it's going to work. So like your heroes might have special abilities. They'll be able to... You can't quite see it on these because they're all greyed out. But as they level up, you can... spend ability points on your abilities and make them more powerful. So if you're a pyromancer, for example, you'll be able to choose which spells you want to level up and make more powerful. So, like clerics might get better heals. We talked about the pyromancer. Swashbuckler might get sort of like, I don't know, auto fire or sharpshooter or things like that. Okay. So that's really cool. I think that's going to be a lot of fun. In fact, I'm going to... Gears, I'm going to maybe send them off and see if they can get... The problem is, on this map, I don't think they can actually get to where the kobolds are. I don't think they can actually cross across this. So I've made a little bit of a base, but... Yeah, you see, they can't, as I was saying, either I've set it up incorrectly or it's not quite working. We'll let them run anyway and see where they get to. Okay, so while they're doing that, let me run back to the walls. I think they're going to try and go a long way around. We'll see. Okay, all right, so Half-Fox just said that the caster is immune to the meteor, the firestorm. Some of the other props that we've got, in the Grasslands kit, there is a cattail prop 3D1, but you had to place them all individually. So we've realized that that's a major pain in the butt. So we've actually... Oh, hang on, let's set this today. So we've actually created larger clumps of cattails and some other sort of swampy-like plants. Where have they gone? Over there. Now, I'll just pause here. Just like in the Grassland kit, you've got quarter height, half height, and full height cliffs. There's been some conversation in the forum this week about having taller cliffs, which I'll talk to the art team about. I think for like the snow zone and the grassland kit, that'd be relevant. They'll probably make it into the swamp kit as well, but I don't know whether you'll be wanting to use them in the swamp kit or not. Maybe to sort of break down some of the detail in the distance. Right, let's see if they can get in. Can you guys walk down here? See, now these special abilities in, everything becomes a bit easier. Oh dear. I'll say that.
Who are you? Ready for battle.
He's doing fairly well. He's got no abilities there. A person with the firestorm. Oh, he's jumping around with it and glitching. So his survival rate's just gone up massively. Presumably he's got all the armor on, has he? Yes, he has, so I should have equipped some more armor, really. Aaron, just to mention, you shouldn't show the item quantity when it's equipped on the character. I'll enter that in the just later.
Who are you?
I think what we'll do actually, let's pick up the loot. Oh no, where's the pickaxe gone? Might have to give one of everything
again. Standing ready.
Yeah, let me go and train somebody up and grab another peasant, because I want to actually use that firestorm spell.
On my way.
Train you as a city watch. Let's get one of everything. I'll come back to chat. Sorry for not answering your questions. I will get. We'll come back to chat shortly. And then let's just equip.
New villagers have arrived.
Let's find out which one it is. No, I don't think it's any of those. I think it's probably added it to the end. That's it. That's the one. Alright, let's I think it's female. Give us some armor as well. I don't think I've set up the stats on these yet, so. But we've done it so that artistically there are sets, so I'm combining multiple sets at the moment, but. I suppose I could. There we go. Let's check the boots on in the right gear. So he starts to wear a set. Okay, that's looking a bit more like a set now. We got the right ones on. No, I don't want to go with that. Okay, so hopefully now. So that's an uncommon set of armor. So let's send you over to join your mate over here. Swap today again. Right, sorry, let me catch up with chat. So MBNC asked about, would campfires serve a function in the game, or are they just for aesthetics? If you haven't got enough housing and they're tired, chances are that they'll go and sleep by the fire. I think that was discussed in a meeting quite a while ago, and it'll be documented, but it's not something we've really looked at in a long time. Matt is asking, are the towers going to be more limited with the crossbows now the arbalists are in? At the moment, I can get 3 on a single tower. I think the cost will certainly increase. I don't know if we'll reduce the quantity that you can put on a tower, but certainly the cost of those, you know, walls are fairly cheap to build at the moment, so we will probably increase the cost of those. Newport's asking, what are the plans for challenge after you've built a city and a working economy? The second aspect of the game, so there's the city building aspect with all the economy, and we've got all the RTS combat and sort of siege mechanics and things like that going in. The other big aspect of the game is the RPG aspect, and this swamp biome being one of the explorable biomes that you'll come on adventure and doing quests to. So that will be a huge amount of playtime, and your advancement of your city will be tied to exploring, so that you'll discover crafting recipes and things like that, and maybe gain culture points, and that will enable you to move up the tiers of the city. So the buildings have three tiers, tier 1, 2 and 3, and the visual appearances are different and the bonuses that you get from them are all different. So it's part and parcel. You can just play the city building and economy system if you're playing maps designed to support that. But in terms of the vision, the idea is that you start building up your village and then you'll start to get quests and then you'll go on these quests and start exploring the world. And it's, I would say, if we do it right and we deliver to what the plan is, which we've got every expectation that we will, I would say that a game would probably last about 8 hours, possibly longer. That is only sort of an internal objective at the moment. But I think judging by how much gameplay there is at the moment and looking ahead at what is planned, I would say that, yeah, it's likely that a world will provide something like 8 hours of gameplay on a single playthrough. Obviously, you probably want to play it through again. Owen Stone says, I would like more types of beer stroke wine. That would be cool. Like they give people some kind of ability. Well, wine is... we do have a winery on the list. We're waiting. It's not in for 0.3. It's actually after, because we want to see what the gameplay impact is of brewing mead. Because obviously it's just another form of alcohol. So we'll have to see whether there is scope for that or whether it would be better to use that sort of memory and coding time elsewhere on another unit. So we'll see on that. Matty's 101 is asking, dungeons, I've been toying with a scenario where killing enemies spawned allies. Oh, it wasn't a question. Okay. Nersal's asking, will there be a stat tooltip? For example, plus 3 armor and stuff like that. Yeah, at the moment it's just a temporary placeholder tooltip. It will give you a full stats overview like you would expect from an RPG game. Sorry, I'm just losing this a little bit. There we go. Okay. MBNCD is asking, will characters react intelligently to special abilities? For instance, if they attack a foe from several different positions, will they go to positions that will put them in those special abilities? Oh, right, yeah, okay. So if you have like a healing aura or not, and a character's wounded, will they go to that healing aura? It's just part of AI. We'll have to see how it develops. I mean, obviously, suggestions like that we would look at. And as we'll start with the basic strategy, and then we'll start to build on that and all the sort of edge cases that what happens when various special abilities are active. Are they seeking healing? So I think you can expect the game and the AI to become smarter over time. Yeah, it's a balance really between making the game fun to play, but also not having too much micromanagement in during combat. So it's a slightly more sort of arcadey feel, but also so that the strategy players can really tweak the gear and have the best abilities and think about what they're going to do and how the battle's going to play out before they go in. So yeah, there's going to be a lot of tweaking, I think, and how much AI we put in there. What we don't want to do is just, you know, so you just select all of your guys and send them in and don't do anything, just sit back and go, ha ha ha. let them take care of that. So it's going to be a fine balance. Crikey, lots of questions today. Nakia Rose asking, will you have trees with moss hanging from them? Yes, I believe they are being done in the next couple of weeks, actually. They're one of the most common swamp sort of pieces of vegetation, so yeah, you can expect that to be going in. Whew, okay. Newport's asking, how will the city building aspect keep... oh, I've answered that one. And some question about interiors, but that's been... Right, some streams ago you showed the interior of building. Does this have any gameplay value, or is it just looking nice? Some streams ago you showed the interior of building. I don't think I did, because it's not in yet. Unless you're thinking about the Sandbox Vision presentation that was done back in June 2013. Could be that. So, building interiors are on the roadmap. I think it's 0.78, something like that. Okay, let's get forward. Sorry, I've not been playing the game at all. So many questions. Stan was asking about loot changing characters' appearance, specifically armor. So that's covered in the Sandbox Vision presentation, if you want to go and check that out. So, what I actually want... I don't think control groups are in yet, though. No, they're not.
Yes?
Okay. Oh, did I kill them all? Oh... After all that, I've gone and killed them all. Well, that's no good, is it? Maybe we'll look at this in the editor. I'm terribly sorry about that, guys. I seem to have killed everybody. There wasn't a great deal of monsters in this. I should have probably set them to respawn when they died. So, yeah, maybe we'll jump into the editor and have a look at this. Yep, let's do that now. Just bear with me. Stonewood 1612 saying it's pretty crazy you're making a model for every weapon. It was one of the few things really that we could show on the character, and also as you start getting better loot, you know, when you get glowing weapons and fiery weapons and things like that, you really want to see who's got those. So we made the decision shortly after launch, actually. If you check out, as I said, keep referring to the Sandbox Vision presentation, I think that discusses it in there. Basically, we've just delivered against everything that we presented in that video. If you compare the roadmap to that video, it's pretty much spot on. Right, so let's just dump down to the swamp. We'll probably have to rename this. Excuse me. Where were we over here? You'll recognise a lot of the pieces. We're trying to follow a lot of the format of the Grasslands kit. So you've got various alphas. So this one's sort of like a dirt with vines. You've got the other ones like the lily pads. which are also in there in the Grasslands kit. You've got things like vines, although I'm not quite sure how useful they'll be, but they're in there anyway. You've got the different types of bushes, so you've got 6 bushes. I'll just sort of plonk them all down. I'm sure we'll continue adding more over time. So 6 different types of bushes to be working with, just to fill out the sort of all of the vegetation. Nursel's sort of talking about the TM. I'm not quite sure where he's referring to that. I might have missed part of the conversation. Folktale's actually a registered trademark now, just to protect our intellectual property rights. Don't think it's everywhere, though, like the TM. Sorry, I'm just catching up with chat. Okay, so talked about the bushes, so let's keep going. We've got the different types of, so these are the hills. We've got the quarter hills that I talked about. Probably best if I just go over here, actually. So you've got all of the pieces that follow exactly the same format as the Grasslands kit. So you create maps in exactly the same way. Terrain painting now, we've got more textures. I haven't created the icons for these yet. It's got the grassland textures in there as well, but I have a feeling that we're going to have to filter this list depending on the biome of the map that you're making. So it is possible to put grassland textures in there, but it will increase draw calls and decrease performance potentially. But for now, they are in there. So this is something we've got to clean up before release it. Jumping down, so you've got all of the cliff pieces that you'd be familiar with. We've got the different waterfalls. So they're all in there. Keep going. We've got various mushrooms, but there's so many more pieces coming for this that haven't been put in yet. So the mushrooms were in the grassland kit. In fact, these are probably something that should be moved into the common kits. But there's also some swamp specific ones which haven't made it in yet, that are sort of much bigger, different hues and colors and things. So there's far more mushrooms as you might expect. The rocks we haven't updated yet, so they've probably got the old grass. So they've got the old grass texture on it. So we need to update those to make sure it's swamp and fits in with the swamp biome. The tree huge are these ones. And I just sort of move that about. That's actually the huge tree. And what I've done is I've used a combination of things. So we want to discuss with the art team, because this is something I was messing around with on Saturday. And I basically just stuck a tree that's got no vegetation on it as sort of a branch of this massive tree, just to give you an idea of the scale. And also we've got more roots now as well. Let's see, what else have we got? We've got all of the trees we need updating. We've brought in the fir tree from the swamp zone in the tutorial. Again, the hue's not been adjusted to match the swamp zone. It is very much a work in progress, this. We have got all the different sort of roots, which you'll be familiar with from the grasslands kit. going through. We've got the different glowing trees. No, so I think we'll be putting in more of those. Right, we've got the walkways. This is what I couldn't show you because they weren't working properly. So what we've done is we've set up a small amount of snapping on these. You can see it's actually only very small, to help you align them better. Although they're not quite working at the moment with the nav mesh system, but they will by, hopefully by the time of release. So we've got all the different, oops, that's not right. We've got all the different pieces that you might expect. So we've got T-junctions, we've got crossroads, we've got corners. If I zoom over down here. So that's just locked terrain tiles. So we've got a corner there. And all of these snap to 90 degrees. So we can, being a swamp, we can make all sorts of walkways. We've also got, I've not used them particularly well in these, but we've also got steps on those so that you can create raised walkways. We've got short pieces, we've got long pieces. So let's, that's got to be lower than that actually. So that's one straight piece, and you've got another one. So it should be very quick to put together all of the walkways over water. We've also got some flat tiles, so flat terrain pieces that have got sort of like pools of water on there as well. Just catching up with chat. Yeah, generally we spend a good couple of months at least on kits, and this has had 2 to 3 weeks, so we've got a fair way to go. Gives you an idea, it should be fairly comprehensive by the time that we've finished. It'll be, as I say, there's no ambience in this at the moment, so mood wise you can expect that to change a little bit. Yeah, the walkways are meant to be really used on water. Let's go to that spawn point. Move that over there. I won't be saving this, so. Let's see what else we've got. On the water banks, so the water colour will probably be changing, make it sort of more milky, oozing swamps. Okay, I mentioned that the temple kit was nearing completion. Now that is modelled, it takes reference and inspiration from the Mayan and the Cambodia. So it takes some inspiration from those sort of jungle temple style architectures, as well as the work that we did in the tutorial. And there's all sorts of sort of etched pieces and everything that you might expect from that. And they should hopefully be ready for 0.2.10. So you'll be able to, if you remember to the Grasslands kit, we've got different kits, like we've got the kobold props, where you could make a kobold camp out of, much like you're seeing on screen here. You've got the undead sort of cemetery kit pieces. We'll be introducing a number of kits like that for the swamp, so that you can create themed areas. And they are designed to fit with some of the monsters that we've got lined up for the swamp. So the swamp beast was obviously, although he's in the Grasslands kit at the moment, he's specifically designed for this biome. And there is an entire race that we haven't yet released that we'll be sharing soon, that will be able to populate this place. It's obviously the goblins' natural residents, so there'll be goblin architecture as well. So I think we shared the concept art quite a few streams ago now, but that is about to go into production, so there'll be that kit as well. So pretty much to the level of the Grasslands kits. We've got a little bit of tinkering around to do, so moving stuff into like common shared kits as well. But yeah, it should be a very fun zone. And then in time, obviously, we'll add portals and the ability to link maps together. And because to do that, we've essentially got to save the state of the map that you're currently in. So if you're traveling from your village map to the swamp, we need to save the state of the village map and suspend that while you're playing in the swamp. That obviously naturally leads into load save, which is being long discussed. As I say, the priority at the moment is adding gameplay. It's a balance, it's like a seesaw, got the needs of gameplay. You know, there's no point adding saves if there's nothing to save. And conversely, if you've added loads and loads of gameplay and you know, people can play for a couple of hours, there's a need for save. So it's just a balancing act, and when we get to the tipping point, that's the point that we'll be adding in load save. But if you want to follow the status, go to the roadmap on the website. The link's on the left-hand navigation when you go to the homepage. And you can follow it on there. So it's under consideration to be brought into the 0.2.x release cycle at the moment. Stonewood 1612 said, have you thought about selling things on the Unity Asset Store to increase the budget? Briefly, for about 5 seconds. The problem with that is that then you have to get into support of those things. And we don't... we might do it after the game's finished, maybe. I don't know. I'm not keen on the idea. Budget-wise, we've got numerous options anyway. But it's unlikely to be something that we're going to be doing. Okay, so let's keep looking around. We looked at those pieces. I've talked about the architecture kit. I've briefly mentioned the monsters, which we'll be revealing soon. And I've mentioned 0.2.10. So I think it's time for a giveaway. So let me set that up now. So just bear with me 1 second. Okay, so it's the Folktale Steam Key giveaway. To enter, you want to type in !enter, E-N-T-E-R. Just follow what people are doing in the stream right now. We'll keep this open for maybe, I don't know, 5 minutes, something like that. Give everybody a chance to enter. Don't forget to follow the stream. We obviously want to grow the number of followers, try and get up to that partnership level so that we can provide the stream quality. I'm sharing on the screen now the competition, just to show it's nice and fair. If you have won a key previously, please don't enter. Well, you know, you obviously can, I can't stop you, but you know, give everybody else a chance to win it. Yeah, Matty 101 saying, selling assets is not something that... it's certainly not something we'll be entertaining before the release of the game. And it's unlikely to be after. So once again, it's the Folktale Steam Key giveaway. It's a key to the full game that's in early access at the moment. It includes the final game when the game is finished. To enter, you want to type !enter. You can see everybody doing it now. You've got a pretty good chance of winning. There are only 19 people entered so far, so if you want a chance to win, enter now. And we'll be rolling for that real soon. If I say this every week, but if you've already got a copy of Folktale, then it's a key that you'll be able to give away to a friend and get them playing. If you haven't got Folktale, this is an ideal opportunity, if you've been following the game, to grab hold of a key free. It's totally random roll. We share it on the screen so you can see who's won. There are a couple of the dev team in the Hangout, so if their names come up, then I'll just re-roll. And then I'll send the Steam key at the end of the stream to your Twitch account. Any more entries before we roll? So to enter, it's just exclamation mark enter, and you'll be entered into the giveaway roll, which will be closing shortly. Yep, you got a pretty good chance of winning. It is only a single key that we give away. We are in development. We do need the funds. We do need people to buy the game. So it's not like we can give away heaps and heaps of keys. So it's just one miserly Steam key, which, you know, it's better than nothing. So, don't want to say this is my seventh time entering. Maybe this time you'll win. You've got a pretty good chance of winning. So, final call. If you want to enter the giveaway for the Folktale Steam key, exclamation mark enter. We're closing real soon. Okay. All right. Final entries. Let's give it about 20 seconds because of the lag on the stream. Okay, I'm going to roll. And the winner this week is... Orwood. Congratulations, Orwood. Your Folktale Steam key will be coming to your Twitch account at the end of the stream. So well done. You can pass that on to a friend if you like. But well done to Orwood. We can go back now into the game. And let's see if we can quickly get back to where we were. Before we do, has anybody got any questions on actually, let me just bear with me a second. Okay, so any questions on the swamp kit while we're in here in the editor? Kirokmar, I think, was saying about there was a potential bug with fishing points. We can probably test that now. I think these are actually duplicates anyway, these three here. But I will... did I change anything? Let me just load that in, make sure. Let's delete those down. I think he was saying that if you duplicated a fishing point, that it didn't appear to be working. So we'll just test that now because we will be loading up. Save as a new version. All right, let's jump across into Sandbox Player. Sorry for the music, but actually the music won't play. That's all right, because I've changed it. I think it's time we can vary up some of the music a bit, so let's change. All right, let's have a listen to some of the desert music instead. And I must remember to turn the sound down so you guys can hear me okay. And I'll bring the camera up as well. All right, so let's dump down one of those, and then let's also test the fishing as well. Because we wanted to do that, so I need to make it nice and close. Let's see, can we go in there? Where are the fishing points?
Building completed.
One thing I will do quickly is I'll
just
get some walls up.
New villagers have arrived.
I can't see in the fog of war where they should be exactly. Yeah, that'll do. It sounds like some people that were previously having issues with Twitch have managed to be having good streams this week. Alright, so they should be able to take out that swamp beast that comes walking around. He only comes walking around because the Navmesh stuff's on the bridges is broken, so. Right, fisherman. Where are you?
Yes, my dear. How can I help?
Yep.
Go fish. Oh, there he's coming.
New villagers have arrived.
Something
right away.
Gold. Okay. A woman's work is never done.
I dropped some loot this time. Ooh. Look at that, polished ruby. Now, you've been following the stream, so you will, when you are
new villagers have arrived.
Mining, you will be able to discover. Okay. You will be able to discover uncut gems. Alright, so that one's fishing. Is anybody else fishing? Right, where's one? Where's the other fisherman gone then?
All right, my love.
Not standing around, are they? No. Well, you go fish too.
New villagers right, have arrived.
There's a bug. There's fish there. There was the fish nearby. Oh no! See, they were fishing. Let's just select all these fishy people there. Right, so that was the original one, wasn't it? And that was a duplicate there. So that appears to be working. Not quite sure about that. One thing you might have noticed is that if the it's green, isn't it, the cylinder? If the cylinder isn't on the terrain, and it's a little bit of height, you'll see that when they arrive at the work point, they'll sort of drift down. So it's important to get the bottom, if possible, to get the bottom of the green cylinder to be touching the terrain. And then you won't get it. You'll see it here, actually. There. See, I wasn't particularly... I didn't pay much attention when I was just duplicating them up, so... you will get that. Just be mindful of that. But anyway, that seems to be working, anyway. I can probably untrain. Let's untrain you. Oh, that's interesting. Could I untrain you? They didn't seem to want to untrain. Okay, anyway, so let's just go ahead and build barracks, because that's what we really wanted to do, and get that gear, and then we wanted to go and attack some monsters with the meteor shower. We need the we need one of the units to have that healing aura as well.
Building completed.
So let's have you guys. No reason why.
Yes,
we can't
do.
Villagers have arrived.
And we just need to cheat, so I'll just say it's a day, and I'll say one of everything.
New villagers have arrived.
Let's get that. Oops. That's selected from first. We'll put some keyboard shortcuts in for these soon. Armor. Right. We've been discussing.
New villagers have arrived.
Inventory and the way that inventory will work. And what we're talking about doing is we're talking about giving buildings inventory. And then you will transfer loot from the global inventory, loot including crafted goods, into the buildings inventory, and it's like a store of tools and gear that they can use. And then units, professions belonging to that building will then automatically choose the best gear. Because while you're concerned about productivity, worker productivity, you're not really going to be sending your professions into combat. That's not what they're for. So we felt that having to micromanage characters in that way for your workers could be a bit painful. So we've decided to complement the system by having it so that they will automatically choose the best gear out of the equipment store that's in the building. You can still directly equip gear, and we may lock it so that that doesn't get overridden, so that they will still choose equipment from the equipment store belonging to the building. But any items that you have specifically assigned to that character will stay with them. And we felt that that reduced the micromanagement aspect of the game, allowing you to focus on the stuff that's the most fun, really. And it would apply to troops as well. Looking at what I'm doing here. Oh, they've already got one of those. Got boots. Leggings, got pauldrons, some got a belt. That's going to be done. We need to give them a weapon. Which is the pickaxe. Which obviously these guys shouldn't have pickaxe.
Ready to serve!
Okay. Go back to the armor. So if you drop armor into the barracks inventory, then they will automatically equip the best gear. And then over time, obviously, they'll unequip worse gear, and then you'll be able to salvage that gear and you know, and convert it into iron ingots, wood and things like that. They've got one of those. I haven't really got a plate helmet there, so let's get one of those. Yeah. It looks kind of cool. Sort of like a Dark Knight or something. Right, and then I want to give you... Okay.
Move along.
Let's go. Actually, no, it's not that way, is it? I have to go the long way around. Let's just send them round there. And while they're doing that, I will catch up on the chat. Rogue Roxy is asking, have you considered publishing the game guide after completion? As a proper physical game guide. No, not really thought about it. Physical distribution is something for the game itself we'll be thinking about as the game nears completion. So we'll go out and talk to publishers. I have seen some early access games actually in stores, so when I pop down to my local game store.
Something to do? Yes, Petal.
Nothing to see here.
She's got a pickaxe, hasn't she? I've seen a couple of early access games in there, actually. I think Planetary Annihilation actually went on the store shelves in early access. I was quite surprised by that. Right. Was it that one? No. Which one
ready.
Was the third one? Have some of that. No, missed. Yeah. Oh, right. There you go. Have some of that. Run. Get for getting that healing order. It becomes
ready
a lot more responsive and entertaining and fun with these abilities in there. So it'd be nice when we get to pad those out and put the actual visual effects in. It will be cool. They got any of these guys? Said to me, I think there's some guys. Oh, run! Let's try electrocute. Get them out of the way. Anyways, what's the one with the?
Ready to serve.
That's it, the one with the pickaxe. Let's go and try and electrocute, see whether it works. I think it's this first one.
I am defeated.
Oh dear. Well, he didn't survive very long against four, did we? Which I suppose you would expect. Oh, and he was the one with all the abilities
ready
on it. Anyway.
Battle.
Go on. We'll add in targeting as well. So at the moment, you know, you can't... when you hover over a monster, much like the targeting in the tutorial worked. Yeah, these guys are... With that healing aura that's massively overpowered. That's rough.
All right, beloved.
Yeah. The healing thing. The rate that it heals at, it just makes him pretty much invulnerable. Yeah, they've got no chance. Well, they're bouncing a bit. That is a bug that they'll need to fix. I'll send him up there. Oh, I so want that arbalist in there. Alright, Halfoxel saying the electrocute is only targeting allies at the moment. Yeah, because it requires an animation that's only on the humans at the moment, but we've got things like electrocute, stunned, you know, with the sort of like Tweety birds going around. So all of that will be in And that's pretty much it. I've killed all the monsters there for this level. Now I'll just check, make sure I haven't missed any questions.
Yes, my dear.
God, you know, I really envy other games players, because I've got such a massive backlog of titles now that I've just not had a chance to play. Just haven't had the time. Just so busy. Like, I've had Destiny for, I don't know, since launch day, and I think I've played it for half an hour. And I really want to play that. Just no time. Okay, so I think we'll keep it as a short stream this week. We shared the Arbalest. We've had a look at the Swamp Environment Kit. Hopefully next week I'll be able to look at the Swamp Temple Kit. And there'll be some more coding to do. There'll be more coding being done, so hopefully we'll be able to show you off some new things as well. I'll update this map to get some of the temple pieces in it. So it's one thing just to show you the individual pieces, but it's obviously a lot better if I can actually show what they look like when they're combined. But anyway, hopefully you enjoyed that. The Q-chan's just joined us now, just as we're wrapping up the stream. Sorry about that. You can catch the stream on YouTube. We'll post tomorrow. We'll post it to YouTube, so you'll be able to watch the whole thing then and catch up if you missed out or if your stream quality was bad. But hopefully you like the way it's going. And we this week are cracking on with 0.2.10. There is a lot to add. I'm just trying to think what we're trying to get so many things into 0.2.10. A lot going on. There's obviously all of the buildings and professions that I shared. Was it last stream or two streams ago? Anyway, I digress. So we're going to wrap up the stream there. Orwood, I will be sending you your Folktale key to your Twitch account, should I say. Everybody else, have a great weekend. A little bit of a shorter stream this week, so you've got a bit more time. Thanks for joining us on this Sunday. Don't forget to follow us on twitch.tv/GamesFoundry, or you can follow us on Twitter at GamesFoundry.com, or follow the YouTube channel at YouTube.com/GamesFoundry. All right, have a great weekend, guys. Thanks for joining us. Bye-bye.